Hey everybody, this is Cheryl the Candle Coach. You know I go straight to it. Let's go. This is how I soak my wood wicks. These came off of Amazon, but I always soak my wood wicks as soon as I get them. As you can see, they're a little greasy, so that's how I know. But I just basically put them in a tin pan. That pan I got from Dollar Tree, the little tray I got from Dollar Tree, the little cups I got from Dollar Tree, and that little vessel right there to hold my olive oil is in a Dollar Tree. But I thought it was so cute. Look at it. Isn't it cute? Well, anyway, I'm going to pour some in here because I can't really see how much I'm pouring because of the glare. I should have did it in another part of my house. But either way, I'm going to pour it in there. Let's go. And I just basically want to cover all of the wood wicks. I want to cover. I don't think I put enough in, so let's go ahead. We're going to stir it up just a little bit. I want to make sure they're all covered fully with the wood. And then I take in soak them and marinate them and rotate them, whatever you want to call it. I just rotate them a little bit because I want the wood, the oil to soak up in the wood. That's what keeps the candles lit. I have never had a problem after doing this of a candle being not lit. You see how I went crazy there, but I can reuse it. So once I'm finished with this oil, I'll just take and dump it back in that jar because I don't use it for cooking. It'll be designated just for my wood wicks because I do sell a lot of candles using the wood wicks. So basically that's pretty much it. I let it marinate, let's say like a steak. I'll leave it in there from 12 to 24 hours. So if I came downstairs and I wanted to do it for 6 a.m. and then when I finish at 6 p.m. I'll just take it and put it in that green cup. But before I do, I'll take and get some paper towels, and I'll take and get the paper towels. As you can see, I'm folding up the paper towels. And I fold it in like four, just enough just to get touch the bottom of the cup. And I just push it down in the cup to hold it in place. So once I'm finished, the oil will be soaked up in the bottom of the cup. And that's pretty much it. So I just leave it like that. And then I have on gloves because the gloves allow me to pick them up easily and my hands don't be greasy. So you don't necessarily have to use gloves, but I'm majority of the time, 99.9% of the time, I'm in gloves. Only because it's sanitary. And only because candle making can be a little bit messy. So wearing gloves is basically for your safety as well as the customers. And I just pick them up just like that. Let them drip, drip, drip a little bit. And again, this is olive oil. I want to make sure I say that, olive oil. And I just drip them and then just try not to make a mess. Okay, and I just let them sit in that cup. They'll sit there probably about 24 hours. And then once they're finished, I'll go ahead and put them back in the bag. It's nothing hard. It's really simple. But if you ever have a problem with your wicks going out, it's for the wood wicks, I should say, it's because of this. This is a lifesaver. It will save you time. I try to keep my videos short because you know I'm long-winded. But anyway, ta-da, that's it. So go ahead and soak your wood wicks right now. See you.